The coronavirus has certainly left its mark on our healthcare system in this country, including a drastic decline in the number of transplants performed over the last 8 weeks. But at UPMC, it was a much different story, and we found out why. Joshua Charchet's music therapy is emotional to watch. That's his wife, Laura, off camera singing along as Josh recovers from a double lung transplant at UPMC. For the past 2 years, he has struggled with three rare conditions, and by February, his only option was a transplant. But then COVID-19 hit.
I can't even like separate the two, like the pandemic and Josh's transplant.
Josh's health was rapidly declining, and in early March, there were still a lot of questions about the virus. Could the donor organ be infected? Would UPMC's transplant team have to travel into a hotspot?
One of the doctors here says that he would be willing to go to New York City for Josh, and I said, oh my goodness.
By April, Dr. Pablo Sanchez, UPMC's surgical director for lung transplant, said they found a donor. But then at the last second, that donor had a COVID scare, and it was now or never.
And we talked to Josh about it. I said, okay, are you okay with this risk? And I said, well, and he understood that he was dying.
Josh's transplant team came up with a detailed safety plan, and the surgery was a success. And it put Josh in a small but fortunate group of people. A recent study by The Lancet found that transplants in the U.S. are down more than 51% since the COVID outbreak started. But UPMC managed to do a record 12 lung transplants in the month of April. Usually, it's about 6. So why the success? Well, Dr. Sanchez says luckily Western PA never turned into a hotspot, so they had open ICU beds. And other hospitals were passing on organs that UPMC's team had a strategy to handle.
6 weeks after he's going home, and if we hadn't made that decision, he'll probably be dead. So that's, he's 31 years old. So how unfair would be that?
It was such an honor to speak to both Dr. Sanchez and Josh and Laura. Dr. Sanchez says that UPMC does not accept COVID positive organs. He wanted to make that clear. In Josh's case, the donor was next to an infected patient the day before in the hospital, but thankfully tested negative before the transplant. Glad to